So in this section, we explore some of the alternative aims that a firm can adopt. Traditional theory assumes that we always maximize profits in the short run. However, investing in a large piece of equipment can make a loss in the short run, but make profits in the long run. Same for investing in some other capital-intensive product or entering another market. Hence, long-run profit maximizing should be a good alternative to traditional short-run profit maximization. However, this theory is not very useful. Why? Because managers can just claim that they were attempting to maximize long-run profits. They can use that as an excuse for virtually anything. The manager can always justify by saying, oh, you know, we did make a loss, but in the long run, it will pay off. Well, in the long run, we are all dead. This kind of excuse leads to jokes in economics, for example, like there was this man who sits in a railway carriage throwing pieces of paper out of the window. Now, another man was curious and asked him, you know, why do you keep doing this? And the man says, it keeps the tigers away. It keeps the tigers away. But the other man said, there are no tigers around here. It's a city. And the man throwing the paper replied, I know. It's effective, isn't it? So we can view this in another perspective. The boss of a company always does strange things. He will spend lots of money in advertising, and he will suddenly stop. He will give a huge salary increase to keep workers happy, and then he will close the factory for 2 months and give everyone a break. He will move the business to a new location every now and then. His deputy asked him, why do you do such things? The boss said, well, I want to make my business profitable. But the deputy said, but it's already profitable. So the boss said, I know. It just goes to show how effective my policies are. So the long-run theory of profit maximization might be similar. It might be impossible to refute such that it no longer becomes a useful theory in prediction and explaining things. Some of you might, a philosopher might relate this to the falsifications criteria set up by Karl Popper.